Let's start. So, pressure due to liquid column. What all things we have started in this? Like first thing we have discussed, how do we measure pressure due to liquid column? So we have seen if depth of the, a certain point at a depth h from the free surface, pressure due to liquid column. Pressure due to liquid column alone is rho g h. Rho stands for density. I believe h d g we have studied. D stands for density. Some of the textbooks use another symbol, that is rho for density. Then we have studied hydrostatic paradox. Whatever be the shape of the container, pressure due to liquid column at same depth is same. In every case, if liquid level is same, so pressure at every point is same. Density is same. Liquid, I mean, same liquid is there, filled up to same height. That means pressure at given depth. Pressure at a certain depth is same. Pressure in this one, pressure in this one, pressure in this one. That means pressure does not depend on shape and size of the container, as well as quantity of water in the container, the quantity of the liquid inside the container. This is what we have seen, right? Pressure does not depends on shape and size of the container, neither it depends on quantity of liquid inside the container. Okay. So we have seen this. Pressure does not depend on the shape and size of the container, neither it depends on volume of the liquid inside the container, right? Then, next what we have discussed. Next we have discussed pressure due to liquid column at any point acts in all possible direction. This pressure acts in all possible direction. It's not like the pressure due to solids which acts downwards, right? It acts in all possible directions, right? Hello. Yes. To be precise, it also acts in upward direction. See, if there's a container, suppose there's a closed container, let's say, and there's a hinge gate. If you fill this with liquid up to this and then fill it up to here, then liquid rushes out from this hinge door. This says that it can exert force up in upward directions. Right? See, if you fill, if there's a container or say, let us say a tank, which is a hinge door here, which can move up and down, right? You fill the water up to this, up to this, up to this, it reaches here. The moment water crosses this level, this water exerts force upward also. So ye pressure jo hai har direction mein lagta hai, not only in downward direction, instead it acts in all possible direction. At this point, pressure or force acts this way, here it acts this way, here it acts this way, here it acts this way. Right? So pressure acts in all the possible directions. Right? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Now, a very interesting topic. Atmospheric pressure. We'll use this word in chemistry also. Atmospheric pressure. Now, what is this? Atmospheric pressure is what? Question is, what is atmospheric pressure? So, it's a very important topic. See, we are on Earth, right? We are on Earth. Suppose I'm standing somewhere here. This is Earth's surface. We know atmosphere of Earth extends up to several kilometers, right? Atmosphere of Earth extends up to several kilometers. To be precise, it goes up to several hundred kilometers, right? Obviously, density of gases there is very less, but still, if I talk of atmosphere, then atmosphere extends up to several hundred kilometers, right? Hello.
Yes.
Hello. If you talk of gases, different gases, then the denser gases like oxygen, carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, the heavy gases are in the lower part of the atmosphere. As you move up, lighter gases are there, right? Hydrogen, even nitrogen is lighter than carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, and other gases are also there, obviously. So traces of methane is also there. Well, a lot of gases are there, right? So all the heavy gases are there in the lower region of atmosphere. And as you go up, density of the gas, like less denser gases are present in the upper region of the atmosphere, right? So atmosphere extends up to several kilometers above Earth's surface, right? Now, consider a cylinder. Consider a cylindrical region in the atmosphere. Consider a cylindrical region, uniform cylinder region in the atmosphere of cross-sectional area A. Suppose cross-sectional area of the cylinder is A, right? So cross-sectional area of the cylinder is A, and whatever be the height, height is suppose H. Though the density is not constant, density goes on decreasing, right? And this height is, and density of gas is very small, but still this height is very large. What? This height is very large. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So the total weight of the gases inside this is huge. You cannot even imagine how large this value will be. Obviously, it depends on area. If you have considered 1 square meter area, then we'll try to imagine what is the weight of the gas inside the cylinder. Imagine, I'll try to explain. See, what you have to imagine is there is a 1 square meter. 1 square meter means this is 1 meter, right? This is 1 meter by 1 meter. Cross-sectional area is 1 square meter. Take this cylinder or whatever it is up to the top of the atmosphere. If you measure weight of the gases inside the cylinder, to your surprise, it will be nearly 1 lakh Newton. Or mass of the gas in this will be approximately 10,000 kg, approximately. Can you imagine? What we feel is gas has no mass, right? But if you consider the entire gas filled in a cylinder, starting from the Earth's surface up to the top of the atmosphere, that is brim of the atmosphere, and if cross-section of the cylinder is 1 square meter, so the gas stored, air inside the cylinder, will weigh almost 10,000 kg, that is 1 lakh Newton. Okay? Hello?
Yes, sir.
So, pressure developed due to weight of this gas. Pressure developed due to self weight of gases inside the gases above Earth surface to the top of atmosphere, is known as atmospheric pressure. This is a very important word. Atmospheric pressure. कई बार आपके दिमाग में क्वेश्चन आएगा, ये टॉपिक सुनने मिलेगा आपको कि व्हाट इज एटमॉस्फेरिक प्रेशर. सो एज वी नो, प्रेशर ड्यू टू फ्लूइड कॉलम या स्टैटिक फ्लूइड कॉलम इज गिवन अ फॉर्मूला, डेंसिटी इनटू ग्रेविटी इनटू डेप्थ फ्रॉम द फ्री सरफेस ऑफ द फ्लूइड. सो वी हैव एटमॉस्फेयर अबव अस, राइट? सो एटमॉस्फेरिक गैसेस आर देयर. सो if you consider 1 square meter area up to the top of the atmosphere, brim of the atmosphere, consider the mass or weight of entire gas which comes inside that cylinder, then if I say pressure developed or built by those gases, so pressure built by those gases is known as atmospheric pressure, and this value is really large. This exact value is 101325 pascals. Approximately, if you want to say, we can value is 1.013 into 10^5 pascals, right? So one atmospheric pressure is a huge pressure. Its value is 1.013 into 10^5 pascals, right? Getting it? Are you able to imagine that atmospheric pressure thing? Pressure due to self weight of atmospheric gases above us, up to that brim of the atmosphere, is known as atmospheric pressure. And that pressure is not negligible, as many of us may think. Since weight of gas is negligible, air is negligible as compared to the density of the gases is negligible as compared to the density of liquid or solid. So as many of us may think that this pressure will be negligible, but no, this pressure is large. It's 1.013 into 10^5 pascals, right? Hello.
Yes, sir.
No. This is atmospheric pressure. Now, evidence, or how to convince that there is some atmospheric pressure and it's that huge. So, evidence of the atmospheric pressure is, if you consider the action of straw. Wait, huh?
Yes, sir.
If you consider the action of the straw, what we do in a straw, we believe that we suck some liquid with the help of straw, right? But actually we don't draw the liquid with the help of straw. Then what we do, we just try to suck out the air inside this. What we do is we simply suck the air out of this. Then how liquid comes out through the straw? Actually, atmospheric pressure, see, atmosphere pushes the liquid outside the straw, and what we have done is we have sucked out air from here. So pressure here becomes zero. So there is no pressure acting in the liquid from inside. Then this atmospheric pressure pushes this liquid out. And we feel that we are the one who suck the liquid out. We just suck the air inside the straw out, right? The rest of the job is done by atmosphere itself. So atmospheric pressure acts on the liquid outside the straw, right? Atmospheric pressure acts on the liquid outside the air, which presses the liquid forces the liquid to flow inside the straw, right? And what we feel is, we feel that it is liquid. Sorry, it is we. We are like drawing liquid in, through the with the help of the straw, but it is not we. It's atmospheric pressure which pushes the liquid inside the straw, right? Okay. Now other evidence. You may not be convinced with this. Maybe you might have seen a device like this. Yeah. A flat rubber thing is there, and there's an arrangement to lift the central part. Right? Lift the central part. Have you ever seen? We put it on the glass or some wall, and there's a knob like this. We pull it out. Right. As a result, it blows out something like this. Have you ever seen? You might have seen in some movies, or in real life also you might have seen. Have you seen this? A flat rubber is there, and there's an arrangement. We keep it something like this on a flat surface, and there's a knob like thing. We lift it, so this portion blows out. Right? Now, there is no scope for air to get inside. Right? As a result, here we have vacuum. So there is no air inside. But atmospheric pressure acts on it from this side. So pressure into area is force. So atmosphere basically pushes it on this surface. And that force is so large that you can even use it to climb on a building. Now, I hope you remember, at least in some movies you would have seen. Have you seen? Why there is so dull? Yeah. Why so dull response? Nobody is answering. Nobody is asking any doubt. Many are there. 7 students are there. Kanesh?
Yes, sir.
Even you are not responding. Okay. So?
Sir, I responded.
Okay. So, this is again an evidence for how strong or how large atmospheric pressure is, right? Got it, na? There are many applications of atmospheric pressure, right? I hope this much is enough for you to understand. Okay. So now we know what is atmospheric pressure, right? So it's clear, na? What is atmospheric pressure? Pressure due to self-weight of the gases above us up to the top of the atmosphere. Right? That's what we say is atmospheric pressure. Okay. Then, next is pressure measuring devices. Pressure measuring devices. Now, pressure measuring devices. Which device we use to measure pressure? Pressure in a sense, which pressure? Atmospheric pressure or difference in the pressure? I'll repeat. Question is, what all devices we can use to measure the difference in the pressure between two points? Suppose there is a gas filled in this container, right? Maybe some LPG is there or whatever, some gas is there inside it. And there is some gas inside this container. I don't know what is the difference between the pressures of the two. Right? So what I can do is, I'll connect a U-tube like this, which will contain some liquid in it. Right? We call it U-tube manometer. We'll not go into the detail of it, but we call it U-tube manometer, right? So U-tube manometer, this is a device which is used to measure the pressure difference between two points. Now how it works? Here comes the important property. So this is a property of fluid, that fluid flows from a point at higher pressure to the point at lower pressure. I'll repeat, fluid has a property that it flows from point at higher pressure to point at lower pressure. Now, let us assume pressure here is more. This is P1, this is P2. I don't know how much it is. Pressure, let us assume, is P1 is greater than P2. What will happen? This gas will press this liquid in this limb, and liquid level in this limb will rise. So liquid level rises in one of the limbs and lowers in another limb. Hello. If pressure in,
yes, sir.
Pressure here is more. So pressure here is more and pressure here is less. As a result, what will happen? Fluid has a tendency to flow from which direction? From a point at
higher pressure to lower pressure.
Lower pressure. This is an important property. Huh? Fluid has a tendency, let it be solid, liquid or gas. So fluid has a tendency to flow from point at a higher pressure, to point at lower pressure. So what will happen? Liquid or fluid in this limb will fall and in this limb it will rise. Now, as liquid in this limb rises, an additional pressure due to this liquid column is developed. Now, see, pressure here was more, here was less. But as the liquid level lowers in this and rises in this, this additional liquid, see, if you remember, we have seen that if there's a liquid filled in a tube, then pressure developed due to this liquid column is HDG, right? Density into height into gravity. So this liquid column additionally will develop a pressure at this point, no? So at certain difference, when there is a certain difference, this flow completely stops. And if I use a logic, this must have stopped because the additional pressure developed by this liquid column balances the pressure difference in the two vessels. Just try to think what I said. The height difference in the two limbs of U-tube manometer develops a pressure which is equal to pressure difference between the two vessels. See, what is the pressure acting here? Pressure acting here is just the pressure due to the gas inside this. What is pressure acting at this point at same level? The pressure due to this gas, additionally pressure due to this liquid column. No?